Hey guys, it's Tom483 here, and welcome back to a brand new video, where today I'm back on the crew with my friend Rio.
Hi.
Don't forget to subscribe to his channel, Mini Rascal. He's started uploading content on there, not too sure how long, but you know, he's uploaded his first video today. Congratulations, hashtag congratulations Rio in the comments.
By the time this video that we're doing right now, by the time this has gone up, my one should have gone up too. So yeah.
So what we're planning on doing today is, we've got two different off-roading cars. Rio should be pulling up in the car park every second. Oh. No. No.
Well, you know, it did really good in the last video. In fact, it won the challenge. So I thought, why not use it again and just rub it in your face, basically.
You're annoying. You know that.
I know.
So as you can see, I've gone for, once again, a sensible vehicle. Nissan 370Z. Alright. Take a look at this, right? Interior, very nice, very luxurious. Not too sure about the mirrors, but we'll forget about them. Two tow hooks on the front in case you want to tow two vehicles at once with this thing going backwards. Yeah, quite practical. Got nitro. And Rio has brought along the brick again.
Well, you know what? Your car is sensible, but mine is better, so... And you know what? I do like Nissans, and I will admit your car is almost as good looking as my one is right now. Are we gonna go or what?
Yes, hang on. Let me tell everyone where we're going. So we're going from Fort Stockton, right down here, next to the Interstate 56, and we're going to go over past the Mountain State sign over to Las Vegas. And let's just say we're going to meet up at the airport. Yeah? Is that a good idea? I don't fully know where I'm going. Don't know. Don't care. It's going to be interesting. So, Rio, are you ready?
Yeah, I've already started driving.
Oh, well, that's just great. The map is still loading in for me. Okay, right, there
we go. And I don't even know if I'm going the right way.
First thing you go... Oh, there's my car in the same colour in real life. Don't worry, they still can't track me. They don't know my number plate. It's all good.
G-H-I-J-K.
I literally thought you were going to say it. No, seriously, don't. Right.
Guys, it's actually doesn't even begin with the letter B. It actually starts with the letter Z. And it ends in the number 6.
Shut up. I know.
They're gonna find you. I probably shouldn't have done that, but oh well.
Right, anyway, Rio, how's your vehicle compared to mine?
It's brilliant, it's excellent. Lots of control, lots of traction, lots of speed. Obviously yours is faster because yours is a sports, mine is a pickup truck.
Hashtag team Nissan 370Z in the comments.
You know, I feel like people are actually going to comment for the 370Z this time, but just because this one won last time and they feel sorry for you.
Why?
And also because, you know, a Nissan does sometimes look better than a Ford.
Sometimes, generally not, but sometimes, you know, I'm not a big fan of Nissan myself, but I thought that this thing, compared to that Chevy that I had before, you know, I just think that this would go a bit better with the rolling roads of the, what the heck, Rio, of the hills.
Well, I'm off-roading.
Alright, fair point.
Simply off-roading.
Hang on, right, we need to take a right here, don't we? Ha! Ah. You got stuck on the barrier!
I saved myself. Great. Oh, would have put me all the way back up here, oh, that's not nice.
So,
I definitely did not hold down circle.
Oh, poop, you wanna miss that thing?
I can just take this.
Wow, where the heck is the road going? Oh, okay, it's going up here. So this is a route that me and Rio have never taken, have we, Rio?
No. I don't know. No.
We haven't.
Not at all. We I've never seen this place ever.
Yeah, it's very
totally
weird.
Brand new. I'm like, what? There's a landmark up there. I don't have that. I've never seen that before.
I know, right? Neither do I. That's why it has a green tick next to it.
I have never got $2,000 from that before.
I know, right? Neither have I.
I got 3,000 instead. I mean, what?
So I'll tell you what we're going to do is we're going to go up here. We're going to have a look at the landmark. Ooh, looks like there's some observatoires up here. Hang on, where the flip is Rio? I bet you, yeah, he's somewhere down here. What's
I'm
he
off-roading.
Doing? Oh, there he is. He's over there. Oh, Rio, my car's stuck.
I'm off-roading because I have a great car.
I just
which is better than yours.
Fully scraped my car. Yeah, well, mine's better.
No, mine's better.
Yeah, because mine... No, because mine... Right, hang on. Let's look at comparisons for a minute, right? In size, mine is better because it's smaller.
Mine's
in speed,
better.
Mine is better.
Mine's better.
In practicality, I would
mine's
say it's
better.
About the same.
No, mine is definitely better.
Now, you have
yours
two wheels, but I
have,
like,
have
an extra flip...
Tire.
Yeah, but... Okay. Oh, here's the observatory.
I can tow more cars than you. I have lights.
How many cars can you tow?
Well, I mean, if you look along the light bar at the front and the little bit at the back, just imagine in your head how many tow hooks you can clip onto there, and then that's how many. And don't say one, because I know you can imagine more than that.
Yeah, but that's only if you want to make a flipping steam train going down the road and then just be like, come on, kids, get in the back. Anyway, let's carry on.
Mine's better, by the way.
There's just one thing that I don't like about Nissan, okay? I feel like that they've taken everything away from the London Underground symbol. They've got a silver version of it and then they just stick their name on it.
Indeed.
You know, just to try and make some of the people in the UK buy the vehicle. What the heck is a school bus doing out here?
Oh, school bus, I want to crash into it. Sorry, kids, RIP.
Is it going to go to flipping Mexico? No, don't say that.
Mexico. Arriba, arriba, arriba.
We love you, Donald Trump. Only joking.
No, I don't. I'm Mexican. I don't like Donald Trump. I'm not even Mexican. Why did I say that?
Yeah,
I'm
you
sorry.
Really sound flipping Mexican, don't you?
Ay, 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 señor.
First bit of off-roading in the Nissan 370Z, and look at the way that this performs.
Oh, I bet it's really bad, because it's a sports car.
It's actually not. Plus, this has been tuned
car
to go to... This has been tuned for off-roading. Yours has just been whatever.
My friend, yours is perf spec.
Yeah, which means that it's perfect. Compared to yours, yours is a raid. Your vehicle is like the person who comes into an argument and says, hey guys, look, I've got the best thing. I'm better.
No,
when actually
yours,
it's
yours
not.
Yours is perf, which means performance, which means it's made... for racing around racetracks, which are just in a straight up circle.
Not any old racetracks. Not any racetracks. Off-roading racetracks.
Yeah, no. Really? Performance is made for asphalt. Not dirt.
Asphalt. Remember that word, guys. Key word to put in your English book. Asphalt.
Yeah, it is actually.
So, school kids, when you're on that prison bus going to prison, or I mean school, sorry, government. Oh, oops, sorry. When you're on the prison school bus, just remember to write that in your little diary or your English book. Asphalt, people. Nissan 370. Rio,
my
the back of my car's falling off.
Ha, good. See, my car's stronger than yours as well. It lasts longer.
Yeah, well, at least mine isn't a Vauxhall Astra Estate.
Do you know why my car lasts longer?
Sorry, I have to mention Byron's vehicle and everything.
Do you know my car lasts longer than yours because it's a washing machine and I use Calgate's washing
machine. I use Curry.
Calgate's. Oh God, Raheem.
Washing
Oh
machines
God.
last longer with curry. Everyone knows that. Raheem taught me that. If you put curry in your washing machine, it cleans it quite well. Shout out to Raheem Razak. He didn't ask for
Feel like
one,
I've
but
done.
he's getting one.
I feel like I've been doing some weird things in this video.
Like
Like that
what?
or something. And then, well, just a minute ago, I shouted at the top of my lungs. You were
The
just talking
weirdest thing that
about
you've done in
curry.
this video is picked a Ford Raptor.
No, that's the best thing I've done.
Oh God. So, we're just heading into Monument Valley now. Well, at least I am. The slow coach in his brick hasn't caught up yet.
Do you know why? Because I'm enjoying myself with nice scenery and a stunning off-road performance. Well, your car is driving on what it's meant to be driving on, which is concrete asphalt. I mean, I'm gonna be embarrassed if I watch this back and I've been thinking you've been driving on the concrete road and you've just been darting your way along. I mean, I
I've
just won't look
certainly been on the
smart.
dirt like all the time. Like I'm on the dirt right now.
Well, you probably are now.
I was on the dirt before.
Washing machines, that's going go with curry.
That's correct. I don't know, like I put curry in my washing machine. I think that the best curry that works properly is probably chicken curry, I'm afraid. Like I know that it's a waste of chicken curry, but you know, if you can really clean out your washing machine and get a smell that smells like Raheem's coat, then I would have to go with a chicken curry in your washing machine. Yes, thank you.
Huh?
All right then. So, as I continued, I saw Rio to my left. Oh, there he goes. He doesn't even know what the next turn is. So he has no idea where we're going or what to do. Right, let's actually look as if we're going to the right and then let's go to the left. Come on, do a U-turn, Rio. Oh, poop. He could probably hear me, that's the annoying thing. So now, of course, he's gonna. In fact, he might actually know where he's going. I should probably doubt him less. By the way, I really like the colour of this Nissan 370Z, you know? I think it's very nice, very exciting and extravagant colour. I'm not too sure where Rio's at right now. He's somewhere along here, isn't he? Wow, that guy must have shot off quite quick. 0 to 100 real quick. Oh, why do we keep on respawning? Okay, there we go. Where's Rio, man? I'll be somewhere out here. Oh, hello, Jimmy Savile. One sixty, 170. Look at the power that this thing has, you know. Isn't it just amazing?
Hello?
Oh, hello,
Hello?
Rio.
Can
How
you hear me?
far in front are you?
I'm behind. You zoomed off
You
while I
what?
was trying to fix my radio.
Oh. You see?
Yeah.
Unreliable. Unreliability right there. Said it right in
No,
front of
you
your
see.
noses.
No, you see, the thing is, I had a packet of crisps, right? And I just couldn't open them. So what I did was,
So you put
I
a
reached
crisp
into the
in the disc
no 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 no
compartment.
no 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 I reached into the glove I reached into the glove compartment, right? I got out the pocket knife and I just stabbed it,
You're
and I kind of stabbed my radio while I was doing it, and then yeah.
You see, sensible people own
You
Nissan
see,
370Zs.
it actually didn't break. It was actually fine, but I thought
You
it
know
because
what?
it's really
There's a
strong,
railway track
so I
right
took it
here.
out.
I
No,
really hope you get hit by a train.
What I did was I took it out to see if there was any damage. There's absolutely no damage, so I just shoved the radio back in and it was absolutely fine.
Yeah, right. You said that you were fixing it.
Yeah, well, I was trying to fix it because I thought there was something wrong with it, but there wasn't.
Right.
So I was rehooking all the wires
Sure,
and everything.
surely you would have checked first. right? No?
Well, okay. I mean, if you stab something with a knife, it's probably broken.
Well, something that I'm missing out on here, isn't there?
That's like saying I went up to stone. It's like saying I went up to someone, stabbed them in the eye, and then forgot to check if he was okay.
If he wasn't blind.
So
one day I went to prison.
Oh right, my god!
What?
Thomas.
What, are you moaning that I called school prison? Yeah.
No.
Oh. At least I'm being honest.
I forgot to bring extra petrol. My truck's running on empty. But luckily, because Ford are smart, they have a petrol saving mode. So if I just flick this switch, now I should have petrol for the next 5 miles or so.
Okay. 5 miles?
Or so. Yeah, right. They really think of everything. They really do think of everything.
Right.
I mean, when I said I was fixing my radio, I certainly didn't stop at a shop to get a hot chocolate and then have to think of a different excuse on the spot.
Right. Well, I mean, I think the radiator coolers are working. Is there anything flashing on my dashboard? No, there isn't. I think the dashboard looks pretty good in this car! Oh, that was close, wasn't it? That was very close. Stay on the line, okay. I'll stay on the flipping line.
That's not my hot chocolate that I stopped in the shop for.
Yeah, I know, that's your fuel.
Yeah.
I'm joking, yeah. It's your bleach.
Definitely.
Because school ruins everyone's life, government. Can you hear us? Can you hear us?
What would actually happen if I put hot chocolate in my petrol?
Your car will have diarrhea.
Just imagine you start driving off and it looks like a bunch of crap is coming out of the exhaust.
Rio, language. You're doing a video, Rio.
It's not like major, really. It's like
major. Okay.
My English teacher used that word today.
My English teacher swears.
Oh well, there you go.
So does Mr. Barchi. Although it's mostly Mr. Hewitt. Mr. Barchi is generally just like, you've...
Sorry.
And holds it in there.
Miss Mitchell swears quite a lot.
She tries
to keep it secret, yeah, but one time I was a student receptionist, alright? And I went down to the office, and I heard her just cussing to herself. Flamboyant pig.
Right, okay.
Oh, sorry, you copyrighted that word, didn't you? Every time I say it, you get annoyed.
Meanwhile, I'm just driving next to quite a relaxing river. You know? Right now, well, the highest speed that I've gone is probably 130 during this trip.
150.
Oh, yeah, sorry, 150. And,
No, that's what I've done.
Hang on, how fast is this thing meant to go? Oh, poop, I can't check at the moment because I'm in a stupid mission. I hate these missions.
You know what, Thomas? Nobody cares how fast your car's meant to go, because the fact is, mine's better.
Right, okay. That's what you think. Yeah, this time I'm gonna win.
It's not what I think, it's what I know.
This is top speed flipping unknown. Are you serious?
I actually think you might win, just because your car is nearly as good as mine, but some people that don't have brains might think it's just as good, or if they really don't have a brain, they think it's even better. So
right.
That's why I'm a bit scared. There's a very small percentage of your audience that actually have a brain and would think that a Raptor is better.
Kaiser. What?
Byron.
Well, Byron's okay. You know, him and his family are sensible, okay? They own a red Vauxhall Astra estate.
Yeah, I know. I'm saying that they have a brain.
Yeah. Kaiser doesn't.
Yeah. Yeah.
And Raheem would just text me curry all day.
Yeah, Raheem, imagine Raheem watches this video. He's like, you comment hashtag team Nissan, I put hashtag team Raptor. Raheem
hashtag team hashtag curry. Why sorry, is it squirrel. Raining? That's true. Are my wipers on? Yeah, they are.
The logic.
Now, as you can see, guys, this car has a lot of good things about it, including the fact that my wipers automatically come on as soon as the screen detects that there is a different change in temperature and rain on the windscreen. You see? Pretty good, huh? Whereas Rio's, you have to turn it on manually because his car is stupid.
Well, you've never actually driven this car, and if you have, you would know that it tells you instantly when it's estimated, not even when it feels, when it's estimated, the weather will change.
Well, you might as well just look at your phone.
Yeah, but that's different.
That's different, really.
You have to turn it on. With this, you just turn your head like.
Yeah, you have to turn you have to turn the car on. You have to shove a key in its plug hole.
Yeah, well, if you're driving,
that
yeah,
was bad.
And you think it's gonna rain? Why would you look at your phone when you turn your head 2 or 3 degrees? And you just see it.
Oh well,
mine's better.
Well, at least mine does it for you. This is quite a nice road, isn't it?
I'd just like to point out
that my car is better. Sorry, what?
No, I'd just like to point out that everyone in the comments, just comment hashtag team Raptor.
Hashtag team 370.
Hashtag team Raptor.
Hashtag 370.
Hold on, I'm pulling over. I need more hot chocolate. I mean, substances.
Rio. Rio.
Yes.
Watch Rio, right? When he gets out his car, all you see in the back of his vehicle is just a massive fridge full of hot chocolate. I forgot to bring fuel, but I bought a fridge.
Hold up. If it's meant to be hot chocolate, why would I put it in a fridge which is meant to be cold?
Because you'll heat it on the flipping dirt or on your tyres or on your engine.
I'll tell you what I'll heat it on. Ford Raptor, heated seats. That's what I'll heat it on. Heated flipping seats. But your car doesn't have that, does it?
Actually, by your statement, it doesn't have heated seats. But what it does have is it does have built-in heaters to the steering wheel, right? That's not all.
I'm pretty sure every car made after 2015 has that.
My Ford Focus has that in real life.
Exactly. Every heated car steering has wheel. That.
I bet yours doesn't have a heated front screen.
A heated front screen.
Yeah. So when you stop the car, the rain or the ice melts off it.
Why would it not have a heated front screen? Why?
Because people who make that are stupid.
Of course it has one. They'd be stupid not to think of it that.
Right, okay.
I can't speak.
Whatever you say. At least it stopped raining now.
Yeah, that's true.
Woo! Massive air time. Whoa! Ouch. Right, I need to get back on the road. There we go. 100% realism. Oh, this thing isn't working properly. Okay, there we go. And it's stuck in gear one. I forgot to change the gear.
Exactly. My one does it for you. And if you don't like automatic, just tap this button right here. Oh, look, it's in manual again.
So it has a gear stick, so then when you put it in automatic, the gear stick is out of use.
No, you see, what it is the gearbox is, like, full of technology, alright? So what it does is When you switch it, no. When you switch it, okay, to automatic, yeah. What it does is it detaches the gear stick, so you can just take it off and put it in the glove compartment, and they're sight your way. They really have thought of everything.
What stupid idea is that? I thought Ford was meant to make you go further, not to make you fiddle around by trying to find the indicator in the glove compartment. Well, maybe not that far.
Why would you need to take your indicators off?
Well, because that's what a typical person who owns that would do.
Well, I'm a typical person that owns this, and I've never done that.
You do in your spare time, just admit it.
No.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what I do in my spare time. Admire this sheer beauty, which looks 10 million times better than your Nissan and your Chevrolet Camaro.
I'll tell you what, if this video gets to 5 likes, I'll be forced to drive one of them. Alright, 5 likes, guys. That's the first ever like goal I've set, apart from 0 likes. If this video gets to 5 likes, I'll be forced to drive one of them, okay?
This is going to be the first ever time that I like one of your videos.
Yeah, you're a flipping idiot. And trust me, I'm not liking my own video.
You're just going to dislike it, or just not like it at all. That's
I'll just not like it at all, because it's still a good video, because my car's in it. The only thing I don't like about this video is you, your hairline, and your car.
I mean, you can't even see my hairline. My hairline looks better than yours, and my car is making your video 10 times better.
But your hair looks like a flipping beret.
I think you mean beret, not berry. Beret.
Beret.
You sound like someone from Essex trying to say berry.
That's how Trollsus pronounce it. Subscribe to Trollsus.
What?
Subscribe to Trollsus.
Yeah, sub to Trollsus. He's a good guy.
Don't subscribe to Mini Rascal, because he's just started.
My door has just opened. This has never happened in the crew before. Why did that guy throw a rock at my car? That's not nice.
A guy?
But do you know what? Ford really have thought of everything. If something comes loose, alright, see these buttons, okay?
You just shut the door again, simple.
Door, bonnet, and tires. Press this. Oh, look, the door shut. I didn't even have to reach over.
And what does it do to the tires?
Insane. Well, you see, what it does is it sometimes they go flat. It has a built-in air pump. So you just press the button, it reflates them for you.
Mine just has jelly in it.
Well, yeah, I mean, every car would have that. But, like, if your tires go flat, it will just, like, you just press the button. And
yeah, but that means that my tires don't go flat. Because then when you pop them, the jelly will just simply flow into that place.
You will see it only has jelly in the front tires.
No, mine is a 4x4 and it has the tires, exact same tires on
yours
all...
Yours is not a 4x4, it is a race car.
Yeah, that's what you think. But before the beginning of this video, I had, of course, had to change the tires. The gyres? The tires.
It's a race car. It has racing tires.
Yep, yours is a brick. Can't judge. But
it still looks better than yours. It's still more reliable than yours.
More flipping reliable. Mine is Nissan, okay? Yours is a Raptor.
Exactly. Raptor is greater than Nissan.
No, Ford is better than Nissan. But when it comes to either a 370Z or a Raptor... Sorry,
so I've already caught
this.
Up with you, and I'm not even driving on the road.
And
that just
your
shows
point
how
is,
much better my vehicle is.
You're mate, I can go a lot faster than you.
Yeah, okay. That's why you're 10 miles ahead of me right now. And
no, I'm not
400
miles
yards
ahead
apart.
Of you.
Yeah. That really makes sense. Well, anyway, in other news, I just caught a glimpse of Las Vegas, which, if I'm not mistaken, is where we're driving to.
Well, no, you're driving to hell because you're in that vehicle, whereas I'm getting to Las Vegas. Whoa, poop! Did you guys just see that? That was impressive.
Okay then.
Oh, look, look, severe off-roading right here. Look at this. Look at this, guys. We're on the edge of life. Whoa, 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 whoa. Okay, brake, 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 brake. Yes, that's perfect. Look at this. This is great.
You see, now last time I came along this road, I took a left up the end here because there was another dirt road. And I'm going to do that again just to show how great my vehicle is at off-roading. Actually, you know what? I've already proven how good this vehicle is at off-roading. I'm taking a right because I haven't been down this
road. I thought you would. No, it's because you're too scared and you know that your car's going to die along it.
No, it's because I haven't been along this road. And I went up that road last time. I went up the other road last time.
Right, I'm going back into first person because I feel like you guys will enjoy that more because the interior looks better than his entire vehicle. Now, of course, as you know, this thing comes with a lot of technology, including built-in sat-nav, as you can see the screen on my right, interactive phone display where you can, you know, call people whilst you're on the move, search the internet, and also get caught by the police because of simple car design faults. Pretty good, if I'm completely honest, because then you can't blame yourself.
Sure. I'm pretty sure every vehicle has that. I'm pretty sure every single vehicle. Nan's car has that.
Yeah, your Seat flipping Ibiza won't have that. I bet.
Yeah, well, jokes on you because you don't have that car anymore. So. Yeah.
What, you flipping bought a new one yesterday or something? What?
No, we just sold it.
So what car do you have now?
Not talking about my real life cars. I'm nearly at Las Vegas.
Full Focus ST.
And you're
like, subscribe.
Behind me.
Yes, I am.
That's nice. No, I mean you've obviously been using Nitro to catch up. So I'm not surprised.
Not really.
Yes, really.
You call mine a race vehicle and then you say that I've used Nitro to catch up.
Well, yeah, obviously.
But surely if mine's a race vehicle and yours is an off-road thing, then mine would go faster.
Well, yeah, but because mine's better at off-roading, you want to make yours look better by making it look faster, so you use Nitro.
Yeah, but mine would just go faster anyways. Oh, wow, guys, look at this beautiful dam. Look at it. So amazing.
See, this is the thing about you. You think it's all about speed. It's not.
Yeah, well, what you need is need for speed.
See, look, you're using Nitro right now.
Am I?
Yeah, you are.
When did you see me use Nitro?
Just now.
When?
Just now.
No, but like what bit on the turn? Where?
Ah, you know where. You know exactly where.
You see, you can't even say that. It's like Ogun Akaro today, yeah? She was like talking about how doing like whatever you do, like taking your arm out the sleeve of your jumper. I know it's completely off topic. She said that that's offensive, and I was laughing. She was just like, "Oh my god, you're gay." I said, "Prove it," and then
How else are you meant to take your jumper off then?
Fair point. You see, Ogun Akaro just got owned. So is her hairline. She should actually go and get that back out the bin.
Generally, if it's offensive to do that, how are you meant to take off your jumper?
Because then she'll never wash her clothes, isn't it?
Oh yeah, that's true.
She's dirty.
I got to Las Vegas before you, so I won.
But as you said last video when you were on it, you said that it's not about the speed and about how quick you get there.
I never said that. I just said I got to Las.
One other thing. Well, this has an ultra smooth suspension, which means it gradually wobbles. Sorry. Carry on. Sorry, I got a bit bored. Your car's a bit boring.
Your face and your ugly car.
Like your big up forehead.
Said that I got here faster. I got here before you, so therefore my car is faster. I just said that I got here before you, and before this video started, you said Whoever gets to Las Vegas first wins. And I got to Las Vegas before you, so I'm
No, you never. I never said that.
I'm pretty sure you did.
Well, thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to vote 370Z. Don't forget to like and subscribe.
Team Raptor.
And we'll see you all next time. Stay awesome. And don't be stupid and vote for him. Vote for me.
Hashtag Team Raptor.
Goodbye, guys. Hashtag